going to pause this real quick. I'm going to mute this real quick because I also want to go over a couple of things. First off, Blazing Saturdays is not a tournament. All right? It never was. It didn't start out that way. The whole thing about Blazing Saturdays that is it's an exhibition series. So it's a chance for people to show out, you know, show their stuff in an environment that is not so high risk, where the stakes are not so high. So if you are new to the scene, if you are new to the stream, and if you are curious about playing, feel free to join in. Don't even trip. Feel free to join in. It's all good. We're all here to have fun, all right? I know I've seen on a few occasions from different people that folks tend to mistake Blazing Saturdays as a tournament. I just want to clarify, it is not. That's not it. Now, with that being said, I do intend on starting up Def Jam Fight for New York tournaments next year. So come next year, that will be on the docket. We will be getting that going. I know that there are folks out there that are very interested in competing and getting some cash for themselves, you know, when it comes to playing Def Jam Fight for New York. I'm going to give that to you. Just wait in due time, all right? So this is not a tournament. It's just an exhibition series, all right? Now. I can understand if you're trying to, like, you know, if English isn't your first language and you're trying to find a way to explain it, instead of calling it a tournament, just say it's casuals. Let's go ahead and get this started. We already got our first contestant, so just to let folks know, our first match will be between the Human Airstrike facing off against Hazy Gray. Also, Airstrike, you got an endorsement out there. Apparently somebody thinks your name is pretty awesome. I just want to go ahead and let you know that for some fuel. Hazy Gray, go ahead and push start. There we go. All right. Go ahead, folks. Y'all are good to go. Y'all are good to start. I'm going to get your names up in just a moment here. We got the Human Airstrike on the player one side, and we have Hazy Gray on the player two side. So we're going to get that situated. Yeah, they had to censor it a little bit. Yeah, because you got to remember, yo, kids might fuck around and play this game. That's not the intent, obviously. That shouldn't be happening, but it happens. All right, folks, so we're going to go ahead and get things started right away. On the player one side, we got the Human Airstrike rocking with Fat Joe, a.k.a. Crack, facing off against Hazy Gray rocking the Ludapick. And we all right. Yeah, you're going to lose. You're going to be crying like in the eyes. Watch close, because only one will survive this one. So this is pretty much as legal as it gets, folks. Crack, a pretty traditional tank, as you can tell. Ludacris, kickboxer. All right, so we got a little bit of back and forth going on here. Hazy Gray just trying to get themselves acclimated, oriented and all that. Nice run punch there to stuff him. Oh, try to go for a grab mix up there. Gets parried. We're getting it started early. You want that. That's the best. Oh, my goodness. He almost got another wall stick. That's crazy. But, yeah, that was pretty much the ideal scenario, though. That's the best possible wall grab animation in the game. Guaranteed stun. Is it enough damage for a stun there? We're going to see. Pops the blazing for the buff. All right, and looking like game number one is going to Hazy here. Is going to get the Blazing activation, pops the super. Throws it to the wall into the finish.
That's why you always bet. Hey, we gonna see the loser post up and come back later or what?
All right, Hazy Gray coming back strong here, getting a first game on the board. Now, just remember, folks, even though this isn't a tournament, we do use a competitive rule set, which means loser gets to change stage and or character. All right, I just want to remind folks, loser gets to change character and or stage, so they do have that right. Obito7893, thank you so much for the follow. Welcome to the Armory. Hypnotize? I don't even remember that song. And it looks like the game was trying to tell us something as we have the human airstrike going to the comp pick. Definitely understand that. Looking to get a little bit more tanky. And not to mention getting a little more damage as a result. And we're going to the power plant here, which is a little more horizontal. Gives a little bit more room for maneuverability, so that way we can space out those dangerous kicks from Luda. A traditional kickboxer true and through. As the thing about kickboxers have a lot of versatility in this game, having the ability to land big damage. And that looks like the case here for the airstrike. Oh, gets the heavy grab for the stun. Good stuff there. It's going for the chain stun extension. Comp, that restless style going in right now, paying dividends. Oh, try to go for the extension on the wall. Messes up the block cancel though. Oh, gets the mix up for the wall grab. Nice combo there with the Brick City Smash. So for those of you that are unfamiliar with the combo system in this game, whenever you see those green words flash up, that is an actual combo. The game does have a dedicated combo system, but you have to fulfill the conditions. If you do that, you get a massive charisma boost. Try to go for a walk for a whiff punish opportunity there. Oh, and this is not good for Hazy. Getting the stun there. Gonna go ahead and pop the activation there. Super on deck is looking for the clean finish. That's such a messed up super. I broke you once, and I'll break you again and again. That's such a messed up super. I don't like it. It creeps me out a little bit. It makes me feel a little icky. I'm just like, ooh, that was nasty. That was a little messed up.
Damn, it's a shame you're gonna be crying like. Yo, pay attention, yo.
It's about to begin. Yeah, Def Jam Fight for New York was definitely ahead of its time, Obito. For sure. In so many ways. Oh, that's the full effect. All right, airstrike using the hidden tech there. I haven't seen that in a real long time. So for those of you wondering what exactly happened there, the way that animations work in this game, when you come off the wall, you do a little bit of a run animation yourself. And what Airstrike just did was essentially use that animation to his advantage. It is legal because it is something that the game does. It is built in the game. It is intentional. And because Comp has the advantage of utilizing both back and front grabs, he has the opportunity to do a heavy back grab to turn him around to start his combo off right away. The decision isn't a bad one because of the fact that Comp isn't the fastest character, so when it comes to trying to capitalize off of wall damage, it can be a little awkward for him. But this way, he is able to make his damage a lot more consistent. So good stuff there to Airstrike for getting that in and also looking to get game number 2 under their belt. Oh no! And there you see it, folks. Comp a little too slow to capitalize off of his own wall combo. That's so unfortunate. Hayes is going to get another chance here, possibly. No, the stun is gone and it's ready to go. Airstrike gets on the board again.
You're gonna be
all right, let's fight.
And you want more?
Also, what's good? What's good, Cool? I see you in there. Dr. Cool in the building. One of the Def Jam OGs. All right, Hazy Gray here, not going down without a fight. Getting that wall combo going. Wanted to get the OTG there, but no dice. Yeah, in Def Jam, there's some situations where you kind of have to wait a little bit before you do your OTG. Sometimes it doesn't work out if you try to do it immediately because the character technically hasn't hit the ground completely yet. Like, they haven't hit that state. Oh, good stuff there with the heavy kick. Oh, there it is. Airstrike going for that combo. The strong hand. A little bit of an inside joke there. Getting that power bomb, putting in work. Oh no, but it didn't chain stun. That's unfortunate. Didn't do enough damage, but that's definitely gonna stun. The momentum has already shifted in Airstrike's favor. He's gonna pop that blazing. Going for that wrestling grab there, getting that stun. Good stuff there from Airstrike, capitalizing off of the situation. This is gonna be a game set and match for Airstrike. Let's find out. Oh, and the stylish finish from Airstrike.
Again and again and again, then one more time. Oh yeah, really.
Good stuff there from Airstrike, capitalizing with the comp pick. I'm liking it. Yeah, I like this. You know, we get a lot of variety here at Blazing Saturdays, folks. So remember, please feel free to hop in on the action. If you would like to sign up for the next Blazing Saturdays, feel free to type in exclamation point Def Jam or exclamation point Discord. If you type in the Def Jam command, you'll get access to the Def Jam Discord where they talk nothing but Def Jam video games, Def Jam Vendetta, Fight for New York, even Takeover and Icon if you dig deep enough. And if you're looking for a little more variety, just type in exclamation point Discord. You'll be sent to the Armory Discord where you can capitalize there to get your Def Jam fix as well as other titles involved. Oh, there we go. We got it. All right. So first match of the night was the Human Airstrike facing off against Hazy Gray. The Human Airstrike took that 3-1. And now we have Ashita facing off against Ranger Peter. All right. There he is. Okay. Bear me just a moment, y'all. Give me a second. I'm trying to update something.
All right. Time for the cage. Heavy hitters only. If you ain't ready for this, we gotta show you the door, man.
I'm gonna run right through you, chump.
I don't think you're ready to fight with me, and the whole state property's behind me.
Hey, we ready?
All right, here we go. We have Ranger Peter facing off against Ashita. Ranger Peter rocking the Ice-T pick. Ashita rocking the Freeway pick. Again, Dante, you should probably check out my streams more. At the very least, the Def Jam ones, because I've run many matches with Hoodie Batman. He's one of the best players I've seen in the Def Jam community. Oh, here it is. I gotta get that sound back. I gotta get that sound alert back. All right, so for those of you that are unfamiliar with Ice-T, the cold-hearted killer, Ice-T is a submission artist true and through and has one of the best head submissions in the game. Your body has in this game, you have different healths for your body parts. You had head health, arm health, and leg health. So for Ice-T, when he gets that choke, that rear naked choke hold, he is putting you in a stun situation that is like this.
You're nothing but a punk. Your daddy's a punk and your mama's a bitch.
Hey, can somebody clean the debris laying out there? Hey man, you know our crew's always okay, looks like they're here to fight. This gonna be good.
Well, technically speaking, Def Jam Fight for New York is a wrestling game. Yeah, it is made by the same people. So expect to see a lot of similarities. Oh, here we go. Ranger Peter showing that keyboard. Controller, it don't matter. Once I got you, I got you. And there you see right there, the head health is just whittling down. So much damage already done at this point.
No escape now.
He's dead.
You're not.
Yeah, you gotta be careful with Ice-T. Ice-T is 1,000% a glass cannon. Emphasis on the cannon. That is the thing about Ice-T. Once he gets started, he's pretty much got you in his clutches. However, if you touch him, if you hit him, he could very much explode. So, you know, kind of the ebb and flow of the situation here. But Ranger Peter moving up two games to zero. Ashita going back to the character select screen, trying to see what they can make happen. Yeah, that's the other thing, folks. This isn't a region locked event. This exhibition is open to everyone across the world. If your connection can take it, you can come on through. Because Ranger Peter is actually not even from the U.S. He is actually overseas. Yes, Def Jam Fight for New York has international appeal. Yeah, Hoodie Batman is definitely turning into the local boogeyman of these parts. Like I said, one of the best players I've faced in all the years that I've played this game. All right, so we're going for that tankiness. Ashita going with the Trejo pick. I like it. I like it. Ashita going with the Trejo pick, looking for a little extra tankiness to help him out in this situation. And also opting to go to the chop shop, looking to get a little more extra wiggle room here, trying to maneuver the matchup that is Ice-T. Serving him that Law and Order. Oh, and we're getting it started already. The wall combo. Let's see if he can get the chain. Let's see if he can get the chain stun. No, he didn't even get the initial stun, and Ashita wasn't ready. No, you hate to see it, but the tankiness is already paying dividends. Ice-T gonna have to put in a little bit more work on that juice stand. Ooh, try to come in with the haymaker from downtown, but gets caught with the heavy kick. Oh, there it is. Trejo, one of the tankiest characters in legal tier. Ashita just trying to stay alive at this point. Oh no, double down. Ashida wasn't ready. All right, looking like a little bit of back and forth here. Oh, gets caught with the full string. They doing strings out here. Oh, didn't get the full combo there. Smart stuff there from Ashida, just playing possum. Forcing Razor Peter to activate the blaze in there. That is the thing. Once you are on the ground, you have access to a true reversal. You pretty much have three different DPs. Well, I take that back. You have two DPs and a grab. Two DPs and a command grab. Oh, but check out this command grab right here. And that is so unfortunate. Ranger Peter is looking to take the game, set, and match with a smooth 3-0 finish.
Your daddy's a punk and your mama's a bitch.
Hey, what just happened?
I don't know. I'm not entirely sure what just happened. All right, trying to figure out who's player one here, who's player two. I'm assuming that Mao Yumisu is on the player two side. He's already hovering over those weird-ass characters, and there it is, the weirdo pick, Rome. However, I was very much schooled in the ways of Rome. Apparently, Rome has a kit, and it's legit.
Welcome to the camp.
I don't think you're ready to fight with me, and the whole state property's behind me.
I'm gonna stomp a hole in you, punk.
Are y'all ready for this?
All right, here we go, folks. We are getting started underway. Both of these players are NA, so connections are A-OK. So here we go. We got Doug Too Swift facing off against Mao Yumisu for the last match of the undercard, folks, before we get on with our main events. Dante getting the party started early with the haymaker from downtown. Oh. And we are getting party started early. Mao looking to get a perfect underway here. And it looks like he's going to get it.
Damn. Shredded up like a dirty shirt and thrown in the trash.
All right.
Heavy hitters only. If you ain't ready,
I'm going to stomp a hole.
This fight's about to move.
All right. Dub understanding the assignment. Goes right back in. Gets things started immediately. Try to go for a mix up there with the heavy kick. Oh, but couldn't get the connection on the wall. Unfortunate. Oh, good catch there with the string. Getting the cash money started here. Nice charisma build. Rome, one of the generic characters in the game. One of the general problems of the generic characters is that they do not have the greatest stats in the game. There are some that are okay, but Rome is not one of those characters. Rome does not have strong charisma build. He does not have strong health. He does have a little bit of damage though. So if he manages to get the setup he needs, he could definitely put something on the board. But he's got to work. Try to go for that heavy kick there. Get stuffed. Oof. Oh, and the wall stick from the run kick. Oh, that was a possible opportunity to get a grab there, but didn't believe. Congro, thank you so much for the follow. Welcome to the Armory.
Oh yeah, that was huge.
little bit of back and forth. Ooh, gets caught. Pretty much fighting from behind here, but it's looking like they're going to get the ideal scenario. Gets the haymaker into the wall grab. Taunt cancel for the charisma. You're going to need it. Oh my gosh. And a chain stun. Hold up. No momentum stun there on the heavy grab. Oh no, but the wall stick, too much damage on the table. Rome is looking kind of weak right now. Heavy grab, kickboxing finish. Oh, there it is. Game number two going to Dub 2 Swift. Turning the tides here. Evening up the score 1-1. Good stuff there from Mao. Going to the character select screen early. Good stuff here. Definitely a strong match for sure. I keep in shape and do my physical fitness. Your heads are numb, so your brains are missed. This pick them up, eat them up, pick them up, heat them up, pick them up, picklehead, pick them up, picky. I roll with gloves and I real sticky. Ripping the mic, I plug it up in your ears. Croizen brewed. I'm coming out like bears, like Rango, Miller Quartz and Bud. I'ma eat them with popcorn and treat them like suds, you duds. Coming out the weak, whack, wiki, wick, wickable whack, black jack. That's a fact, right and exact behind your back. The funk rhyme and master, blaster. Kicking up in a brainstorm, rainstorm, rap storm, rap form, rap time, rap rhyme, rap blast. I'm here to fail and pass, you continue. Furthermore, on the hype tip, I roll and rock, rock and roll, jazz and pop, rhythm and blues, dance and fusion, brain confusion. Look at the lights, what a night on the town.
This song is so stupid, I swear.
Large, big shout on the East Coast. Cause I'm Papa Lodge, big shout on the East Coast. I'm Papa Lodge, big shout on the East Coast. Now I'm back to funk, freak the funk. All right, here we go. The next pick underway here for Dante.
Yes, here we go in the gauntlet.
Oh, we're getting started immediately. Let's keep it moving. All right, we are even one game apiece here. Mao Yumisu going to the Manny pick. Now, the thing about Manny is that Manny isn't the strongest character either. But Manny's got a little something going on for himself, too. Definitely has a quick kick-punch combo that you could very much get caught by if you're not paying attention. Dub basically just trying to take his time here. Mao Yumisu going for the gauntlet pick. Setting up picking the smallest stage in the game. Trying to ensure that Dub isn't really able to run away here, but it looks like that's not gonna work out in his favor. Oh, and a nice block cancel combo there. Nice little amount of damage. Blazing activation on the table for Swift here. Gets the freeze frame, but that's a run. That's a run attack. You gonna get the parry? No. Yeah, for folks that aren't aware, run attacks can be parried. It is run counters that cannot be parried. And there's that quick kick punch combo there. Those light kicks, those light punches, that 1-2. Gotta be careful there. But for all his speed, Manny does not have the greatest damage output. However, he does have access to the Street Fighter style, which gives him access to that great haymaker. Oh no! And an unfortunate drop there. Oh, try to get the wall stick from the heavy punch. Good interrupt. Pretty much anybody's game at this point. We are in kill range for Manny here, so Mao could definitely make something happen. Oh, gets the wall stick. That's not good. Gets the best wall grab. No! When was Double Down? Oh my gosh! Such a lucky break for Mao. Mao Yumitsu trying to get something started. Gotta be careful here. We are pretty much at that point where any straight hit could turn into a wall grab. Enough damage has been done. Oh, no dice on the wall grab there, on the wall stick. Good catch there. Dub is trying so hard to get the wall stick from that heavy punch, but at this point, it might just be better to go for the kickboxing combo. Right. All right, so we're going back to the character select screen for Mao. Remember, folks, this is a first of three, so whatever character Mao picks at this point is going to have to bet the farm on it. I'm about to say, like, boy, you better not. All right, and in classic Mao Yumitsu fashion, it is going with another awkward pick. Getting those funky characters in, going for the Flavor Flav. That Drunken Master style. All right, so we're going to go ahead and get it going. There you have it, folks. Flav is the pick.
Hey, 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 hey. Yo, like this, like that.
All right, I want to see some blood out there.
All right, now, the thing about Flav is that Flav is definitely a wet paper bag when it comes to that health. So Mao is going to have to be very careful not to get caught by any combos here. However, Flav is definitely a very elusive character, having access to a strong run kick, strong kicks in general. But again, that health, you got to be careful. Dub. Getting it early. So much damage. I'm surprised that didn't stun. Oh, good interrupt there. Woo, try to get the flip kick. Gets the other one. Nice with the run kick there. And there you have it. So fast, so much range. Puts him in a low profile state, so the way that you actually can respond to it is limited. Oh my goodness, three of them from downtown. But the double down. Oh, good stuff there with the heavy kick. Oh, good conversion there with the grab. Dub trying to close it out. Gets the taunt cancel. Close it out, gets the game set and match. Taking it 3-1 over Mao Yumitsu.
Alright, this ain't good. Shit's going down at the after party tonight. Please believe that.
Alright, good stuff to our competitors. Once again, Swift coming through with the fly finish. 3-1 over Mao Yumitsu. Good stuff to both of our competitors. Thank you so much. Yo, I'm excited. We have probably one of the most winningest players in Blazing Saturday's history. Scorpion's been winning matches since the show was called Blazing Fridays. This man's been around for a minute. You know what I'm saying? However, We got a new one. We got somebody who's a little dangerous. We got the Hoodie Batman himself. You know what's crazy about this cat? This cat is so dedicated to their name that they literally only appear. They only appear like at night and very infrequently. Like, you have to catch them like a Pokemon. Like, they appear for a brief moment. If you don't get them then, you're not getting them then. But it's all good because we got them here, and I'm ready to see some action. How about y'all? What y'all think?
Come on.
Come on, bitch. All right, so here we go. We're going to go ahead and let both players get themselves acclimated. This is going to be interesting here. We have Chang facing off against Bo. Bo, the tankiest martial artist in the legal tier. You got to have your combos ready. And even still, you gotta hope it works out. Chang, though, definitely a very high damage, very, very glass cannon character. Has the ability to get the damage on the table if he gets the setup he needs. Oh, good catch there. Hoodie Batman, a very elusive fighter. Likes to utilize the ring. Likes to utilize the mechanics to his advantage. Definitely a tough cookie. Tough nut to crack. Scorpion just playing it safe, however, themselves not taking any unnecessary risks. Understandable. I know things are seeming a little slow right now, folks, but I'm telling you, the moment they get a clean hit, the moment anybody gets a clean hit like it looks like right now, shit's about to get real. Oh, we're getting the first hit started. Oh, wow, and no stun on that one. Bo, for all his tankiness, does not have the most damage. Chang definitely has the advantage in that regard, but still, good stuff there. Getting started early from Hoodie Batman. But Scorpion looking to just get those small strikes, those quick strikes. Just trying to mount the damage wherever they can find it. Wearing down that tankiness. Good run counter. Oh, gets the grab. However, is it enough? Oh, we're going for the guaranteed stuff. Good stuff from Scorpion. Oh, what a read there from Batman. Oh. No taunt cancel, though. Looks like they're not going to need it. Gets the chain stun. What? Oh, he got it anyway. He still got it. He didn't believe. Oh, you hate to see it, chat. You hate to see it, chat. Uh-oh, he's falling off the wall. It doesn't matter. He's going for it. He's got the full combo. He got it. Oh my gosh, what a start.
Damn. What you got?
Hey yo, that fight's over, people. It's over.
I warn you all, the moment one of them gets a clean hit, that is on the flow. It might just be a kill combo.
Hey man, you know, hey,
come on.
Ooh, we gonna be in for a wild ride, folks. Get ready. And this is the main event, so this is a first of five set, baby. We in for the long haul. Uh-oh, flip kick on deck. That's a good sign if you're Scorpion. Yeah, we're going for the big stuff now. Getting those combos in, getting those hits in, getting that stun in. Oh my goodness, so much damage. Oh, try to go for the full loop there. No dice, still gets the OTG. Charisma built up, looking to get that blazing activation. It is now official, folks. That freeze frame is on the screen. Scorpion popping early, looking to get the buff on deck. For those of you that are unaware, the blazing activation, the blazing mode does give you access to increased damage and defense. So combos that may not have stunned before definitely have a stronger chance of stunning in this mode. You do more damage overall. However, you are still human at the end of the day. Oh, there it is, that secret bow tech. For that grab specifically, if he gets it, he actually has a chance to OTG for a guaranteed stun. Batman with the execution gets a taunt cancel before going for the wall extension. now we're getting to the mix-ups, chat. The conditioning is settling in. Chain stun. Classic. Surprise Scorpion has it going for the punch-punch kick combo for the wall stick there. As soon as I say something, I'm so sorry, Batman. I'm so sorry. I take full 100% responsibility for that. That is 1,000% my fault. Oh, and here we go, folks. Scorpion.
What you got now, kid?
Up 2-0.
Oh, I felt that one.
All right, so here we go. I just want to make sure folks are aware Scorpion is coming out straight out of Norway. Europe in the building. Got a little bit of national pride on the line right now. Ooh, gets the grab. Oh, gets the full combo. That's looking like a stun. Yes, it is. Getting that neck snap. Oh, goes for the heavy punch. And I like the tactics that Scorpion is using. Not going for the OCG because he knows Batman is waiting for it, but trying to bait out a wake up by using his 5KK at a range where it's not going to go for the OCG animation. So good stuff from Scorpion there. And good stuff from Batman there, getting the mix up, but is not getting the combos that they need. That's so unfortunate. A brief moment of exposition there. The game does have a RNG factor when it comes to your opponent sticking to walls. While them sticking to a wall does give you enough time to grab them on the wall, if you go for a strike extension, if you try to go for extension using strikes, there is a possibility that they may fall off before you finish. So you gotta be careful there and bow with the magic fingers. All right, Bo going for that chain stun. Reposition so he gets the wall. Oh, and you get the ideal setup there. Oh my gosh, that was so nasty. But again, the RNG kicks in. All right, here we go there. That punch heavy kick setup. So dangerous. Can somebody clip that? I saw that shit. All right, here you go. You gotta be careful. Oh, gets the parry plus. That is a key parry there from Batman. Gaining access to the blazing mode. He's gonna get that extra damage. Going for the super chain. Not a strong character, not a tank character at all. So that super is gonna stun. Batman gets on the board. All right, folks, we got a game. Remember, this is a 1-5. Hoodie Batman taking game number 3, making the score 2-1. Scorpion opting to go for the character select screen here. Now, remember, loser has the opportunity to change character and or stage. They can choose either or. They can do both. It's up to them. All right, so it's looking like a stage change. And we are going to the gauntlet. The intense version too. This is my favorite. Where they get the banging on the gate, banging on the bleachers. You just hear all the commotion, the chaos. So here we go, going to the smallest stage in the game. This is a volatile stage, especially for a martial artist, gaining so much more access to wall scenarios. Oh, and a beautiful parry from Batman. Give me some. Batman getting the party started early. You thought this was a stage for you? Oh, are you mistaken? Oh, no dice there on the heavy kick. but gets the grab anyway. All right, and there you go. The downs have been reset, so that's going to be a stun, folks.
The heat's on now, Daddy.
Woo, and Batman making short work of that match right there, taking advantage of the potential counterpick situation, using the stage to his advantage as opposed to Scorpion doing the same. And we have a game, folks. We are 2-for-2. Score is even. I told y'all we are in for the long haul. What did I tell y'all? I told y'all the moment one of these cats gets a clean hit, somebody might die. Somebody might die tonight, chat. I'm telling you. Oh, gets the run kick there. Catches him with the grab. Nice bit of damage there for Batman. Oh, he's feeling it. He's parrying now. I told y'all, Batman's serious. The local boogeyman at it again. Gets the chain stun for the blazing mode. This is not looking good. I like that, Cool. I like that. All right, let's see what we got. Oh, no. The RNG kicked in. Oh, the game blessed him. The game blessed him, chat. Oh, my gosh. Oh, that's so unfortunate. Yo, he got almost all his health back. He did so much work. But I told y'all, Bo is not the damage master here. That is Chang's job. However, Bo can take it. Oh, he's trying to go for the kill there, but the game is not cooperating. That RNG is not working out in his favor right now, but he's still going. Oh, yo. Whoa.
We're just getting started.
Holy shit. Son.
What? What you got, kid?
Oh my gosh, this match is crazy. And for those of you that are wondering why they're taunting so much, just as a reminder, stamina constantly goes down in this game. Running costs stamina, and the stamina naturally deteriorates. So you use taunting to essentially slow the process. If not, get some extra charisma for yourself. Oh, Scorpion trying to bring him to that gate, but didn't get it. Oh, no. He got unstuck from the wall on that? That's crazy. All right. The game giveth and the game taketh away, as you can see right there, chat. Both players not able to get the wall combos they need. So Scorpion's going to go for what works guaranteed. However, Chang's super is not the strongest. It may or may not stun. And he got it. Looks like enough damage has been done at this point. Gets the wall stick. Gets the combo, but no kill. He didn't get it. No. Bo lives to fight another day. I fucking warned y'all. I told y'all. I told you. I ain't gonna lie to you. I ain't gonna play you. I'm telling you what's up. I know. I'm telling you what I know. All right. All right. There it is. Easily the most contested set, the most contested game of the set. A lot of back and forth there. Definitely a good show for the spectators, for sure. We got 3-2. Scorpion up one game. Needing to hit 5. If this was a tournament set, I know Batman would be pissed right now. Oh, yeah. Hoodie is definitely making Scorpion work for this. I told y'all. This is – I'm not going to call him the local boogeyman for nothing. Y'all know me. I don't give out props in this game often. You gotta earn that. You gotta earn that from me. Batman has 1,000% earned it, and so has Scorpion. Scorpion, the hell spawn, facing off against Hoodie Batman. He ain't even got a suit, just a hoodie. He don't need a suit. He got these hands. The hands are enough. I have no idea how long he's been in the community, but he definitely had to have joined within the past couple of years. Because he wasn't around when I was traveling for this game. When I went to CEO, the year that I got third, I didn't even know if he was there. Oh, what? Oh, no. That is not what you need right now. No.
We call that a blackout, baby.
He joined in August of this year. There you go. He's only been here for a few months. He hasn't even been here for a full year. Imagine what can happen in the next 6 months. Imagine. And I told y'all, next year I will be doing tournaments, and I guarantee you Batman will be there for at least one of them. He is going to show up. I told you, he doesn't show up often, but when he does, it's always a show. Yeah, Bo said, what iframes? He told him, fuck them iframes. Oh, my gosh. What is this match right now, yo? What is this match? Yo, Scorpion is thinking about it? Oh, my goodness. Yo, you know it's real. You know it's real. Because Chang is his main. Scorpion mains Chang, so if he gets to the point where he's thinking about switching from that, you know you're doing something right. Uh-oh. Really? Really? Interesting. Okay. Let's see what you got. You didn't mean to pick it? All right, all right. Just go back to character select. Just go to character select. Just to let you know, daytime scrapyard is legal. That is legal. All right, so the Luda pick is real, folks, and we are going ahead and getting started with game number 7. We are 3-3 right now. It's been a lot of back and forth action nonstop. I know y'all love it. And we going to the after hours joint. We going to the scrapyard. The largest stage in the game, definitely utilizing that space. Easily one of the best counter picks you can do for facing off against a martial artist, because one of the key details of the martial artist kit is having access to wall scenarios, whether that be utilizing wall attacks, wall combos, or just keeping your opponent in the corner to where you can mix them up all day. All of those things revolve around the wall. So picking this stage definitely helps out Scorpion in this regard, because now he can just play the lame game. As you can see right there, he's just running around, playing the space, playing it out, slowing it down. But Batman said, fuck that. I'm watching you, boy. Luda's got one of those too, so you know you gotta be careful. Exactly. So picking a stage that either doesn't have walls or makes it really difficult to access them is a great counter pick when facing up against a martial artist. Batman here trying to do his best to wait it out. It's just building up that charisma, so playing the smart game as well. He's like, all right, you gonna run? I'm gonna build up this meter. That's fine. Yeah, you know, I'm just getting stronger with time. And there it is. And there that is. Oh, that's unfortunate. It gets the heavy grab there for the extended grab time. So he's getting the wall extension. RNG is definitely playing a factor here. You saw it last game. Both players weren't able to land solid hits on the wall. And we were on the smallest stage at that point. You know? I told y'all, we in for the long haul. Who said Def Jam don't have neutral? I'm telling y'all, this is... Listen, I'm going to say this again, and I keep saying this shit. Def Jam Fight for New York is one of the greatest fighting games I have ever played. It is one of the most balanced fighting games that I have ever played. And that's real shit. That is 1,000% my honest opinion. Everybody has a parry. Everybody has a grab. Everybody has the same wall combos. Well, not the, like, everybody can do the same basic wall combo. What, like, the advanced shit, that's character specific. But everybody can do wall, everybody can do Irish whip into the wall, wall grab, right? Or two hits into a wall grab. There's no, like, oh, well, you play this character, so you can't actually do that. Everybody gets to do that. Everybody has a parry. What kind of parry is character dependent, but you have it, you know? Everybody has a reversal, right? You get knocked on the ground, you have a wake up. Woo! And a beautiful parry there from Scorpion. Keeping an eye on him. Oh no, he was trying to get the wall there, but hit the awkward spot. No, I'm with you, AXG. I'm with you. Real shit, Def Jam ain't but one-on-one Marvel. Real shit. If you take the assist characters out, right, you just say, oh my gosh. Yo, we gonna talk about that later. Right now, we gonna talk about this. Time's up. That's a definite stun situation there. Going to get the chain stun too with the next snap. Oh my gosh. We have fought long and hard, folks. And we are now at the promised land. Hoodie Batman takes the lead. 4-2-3. I told y'all. I told y'all. These motherfuckers have been slugging it out. I swear. Megan Channing, thank you so much for the bits. Appreciate you. I also just want to let folks know this channel does run ads, as I'm sure you've already experienced. We do that because we got to pay bills around here. If you would like to no longer see ads and messing up your viewing experience, please feel free to subscribe to the channel. A tier one subscription isn't but $5. The same cost as most fast food combos. The value menu, right? Don't act like you don't know what a 5 for $5 is. But yes, the channel does run ads regularly in order to help out with channel revenue. If you do not wish to see ads, all you got to do is hit us up with a tier one subscription to the Armory. If you have Amazon Prime, you can link that to your Twitch account to unlock the Prime Gaming benefit, which does allow you to sub for free. Of course, all support is appreciated. Thank you to everyone who came out tonight to check us out. Oh, try to go for a grab there, but Batman was watching. Batman is always watching. Oh, try to go for a mix up there. No dice. Again, we are going to a counter pick stage, the Heights. decent amount of space, allowing you to maneuver. Also, not much access to wall scenarios. Those two little pillars that you see there, those little small columns, if you want to call it that, those are the walls. Everything else is either no wall or the crowd. You can try depending on the crowd, but the crowd has RNG built in on itself. They may grab, they may push away, they may not do anything. Scorpion attempting to utilize the stage here to help them out. Definitely getting a good start here. It's looking like a little bit of a reversal of the last match. This time, Scorpion with the meter advantage and the health advantage. Ooh. Oh, gets the wall stick. The crowd member helped out. And that's going to be a stun. Bringing them over to that wall area. Oh, but no blazing. That's unfortunate. Definitely could have been a kill scenario there. Ooh, block cancel to the blazing activation for the extension. I like it. Beautiful sequence there from Scorpion trying to maximize as much damage as possible. Yeah, get up. Hitting him with the OTG there. Forcing Batman to make a choice on whether or not they want to continue to stay on the ground and play possum or get up and fight. You're taking no- what? Batman opting to play it safe here. Not letting Scorpion take advantage of their blazing mode. Smart stuff. Ooh, gets caught with the run kick. Wake up. Cash money. Oh, conditioning is now in effect. Wait a second. Excuse me? He got that wall? Oh, no. That's so unfortunate for Scorpion there. Wow. But the game blesses him. Even the game was like, nah, we're not going to let that stand. We're not going to let that rock. Man, fuck Crow and his RNG. Crow's RNG is so ass. All right, here we go. Going ahead and popping the super early for the damage. Oh, my Lord. No! Oh, no! Scorpion lives to fight another day. Batman wanted the wall, but wasn't close enough. Even Scorpion thought it was over. He even put the GGs in there. You gotta believe. Watch and learn. The theme of the night chat is you gotta believe. The power of belief. Ooh, with the parry. All right, gets the wall this time. Gonna see if the gut system kicks in, and it's look like it's not enough. Uh-oh. Alright, gonna guarantee the wall this time. No! The game did it again! Son! How? Oh my goodness, the game is blessing Scorpion right now. The stage is paying dividends right now. Scorpion's got to be careful, though. He's pretty much one hit away from being blown up. Same with Batman. Batman getting the parry. Will he get the wall? He will. And he will get the finish. Batman takes the set 5-3.
Bang, bang, homeboy. You dead.
Yep. More rooftop action tonight. Let's move on.
Ooh, buddy. Oh, my God. Goodness. Now, was that a match? Was that a motherfucking match? Great stuff there from both players.